As a medical student, you will learn many subjects. Physiology is one of them. But what is physiology? And why learn it? We will see in this video. In simple language, physiology is the study of how the body works. The human body is made up of different organ systems. So in human physiology, we study how these organ systems and organs work. Like how the heart works, how lungs work, and likewise. Before you start studying physiology, it's important to understand how it relates to other subjects that you will be studying. This is the overall position of physiology in medical education. Let me explain how all these subjects are arranged. See, the structural organization of our body includes these levels: organ systems, organs, tissues, cells, and molecules. Now, when it comes to treating a patient, broadly there are two aspects that you need to learn: the theoretical part and the practical part. Theory can be further divided into the study of a normal healthy body and the study of abnormalities. For a normal healthy body, we study the structure and functions at all these levels that I mentioned earlier. And this brings us to individual subjects. Broadly speaking, in anatomy we study the structure at the organ system and organ levels. In histology, we study the structure at tissue to the cell level. In biochemistry, we study the structure as well as functions of biomolecules. In physiology, we study the functions starting from the organ system level all the way up to cells, and sometimes even organelles. The organization levels are mostly relevant in these subjects only. On this side, they are not so relevant. Here, in pathology, microbiology, and forensic medicine, we study the theory of how abnormalities are produced in the body. In pharmacology, we study the theory regarding drugs that we can use for these abnormalities. And finally, in clinical subjects like medicine, surgery, pediatrics, etc., we learn how to apply all this knowledge practically in providing healthcare services. So these are the positions of all the subjects that you will be studying. Generally, they are studied in this order. We first study normal structure and functions, then these subjects, and finally clinical subjects. Now coming back to physiology. As I said earlier, it's the study of how organ systems, organs, and cells work. Needless to say, to study the functions of any organ, you need to understand its structure first. And only after you understand how the body normally works, you can understand how abnormalities are produced and how to treat them. Let's take heart for example. In anatomy, we study its structure. After that, we can study how it works in physiology. Then, using all this knowledge as a base, we can study how the heart functions may become abnormal in pathology, and ways to bring it back to normal in pharmacology. I hope you now understand what is physiology and why it's important to study it. Lastly, one more point regarding this arrangement of the subjects. Please remember that these are overall positions, and there are no clear-cut borders between any subjects. For example, if you start digging deeper and deeper into physiology, you will end up in biochemistry or molecular biology without realizing any transition. So, that is it for the introduction of physiology. I hope this video has also added some clarity to your entire roadmap of medical training. That's it for this video. You can find notes and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you liked this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.